Sa showbiz talagang bittersweet yan. May mga times talaga na magiging masaya ka, magiging malungkot. And I didn't really realize how much criticism all these artists get until I was one of those artists. Ako po mismo, I didn't really expect myself to stay this long here in the Philippines and in this industry kasi hindi naman po ako yung nanalo sa sinalihan kong contest. I guess nagkaka-doubts din ako sa sarili ko because nag-start yun siguro nung bumaba boses ko when I hit puberty. Kasi I was used to singing songs that are high and for me na parang hindi ko kailang mag-effort masyado into singing these songs. Tas nung bumaba boses ko, there was a year na I lost my falsetto. Hindi ko na nakakanta yung mga ganong mga tipong kanta. Parang for a year, puro pop songs lang kinakanta ko tsaka mga madadaling kante, iniisip ko, kaya ko pa bang maging relevant sa tao? Kaya ko pa bang i-pursue tong ginagawa ko? And every day talaga is a battle between you and yourself to keep on doing better. It's true that there are a lot of people who will be better than you, who are better than you and can take your place at any moment. So it's about proving yourself every day and trying to be better. I think that's a problem in society today, especially in the Philippines. A lot of people are so quick and easy to judge other people sa nakikita nila sa TV or on social media. Stereotyping people nowadays, parang it's not necessary. Like, why do you have to do that? And I know that a lot of people are really quick to put people into different stereotypes. For me, that's something na I've told myself na din, that you really can't please everyone and you can't change the minds of people basta they're fixed onto that. Usually, I ignore all the bashing and the criticism I get, pero gusto ko ring sumasagot kapag alam ko namang parang masyado na. And depende rin, minsan mas sumasagot ako sa mga taong binabash yung family ko or relatives ko. Mas nasasaktan ako dun kaysa sa mga sinasabi nila tungkol sa akin. Tao din po kami. All of us go through a lot at the end of the day. A lot of us go from having so much social interaction, going from shows or shoots to, you know, going home and having all the silence. Papaisip ka na lang minsan kung worth it pa ba yung ginagawa mo and kung bakit ka nandito. I feel like there's always going to be those times, especially kapag nababurnout ka na minsan. Ewan ko lang, minsan nakatitig lang ako sa ceiling. Parang tinitake in ko yung silence and everything that's been happening for the past few years. May mga times ako na ganun. Ewan ko, dramatic ako minsan. Pero weird kasi totoo palang minsan darating ka sa mga point na ganun. And you feel down. Hindi mo alam kung anong nararamdaman mo. Ayaw mong magkwento sa ibang tao. Parang gusto mo na lang sa sarili mo lang muna. Important din yung, syempre, yung having your family there, having a healthy support system at the end of the day that you can always go to. They're very supportive ever since. And I guess what makes me stronger is the fact na nakikita kong may mga tao akong napapasaya sa ginagawa ko po, may mga tao akong nai-inspire. And although hindi ko nare-realize yun minsan, but may mga taong hinahangaan po ako and people who actually look up to the things I do. I guess one of the things that made me stay dito po sa showbiz was my passion, of course, for music, my passion for singing. Dream ko po talaga to eh. You always have to find that drive, like what pushes you, what motivates you to stay here. It's important also to get advice from other people who are also in the same field as you, especially dito sa industry, kasi they can relate to the things that you go through as well. When I have days na feeling down ako or feeling a bit off, I like to enjoy watching feel-good movies, and also it helps to be surrounded by positive energy, positive people, people who will lift you up. Honestly, it helps minsan to cry it out, just take in everything. And it's not just because this day or this certain time in your life has been all sad and everything. It doesn't mean that the next few days and the next few weeks or months are going to be the same as well, kasi everything passes nga naman. Mag-adjust na po yung boses ko and hindi na ako pumipiyok pag nagsasalita or kumakanta. I kind of regained the confidence that I kind of lost during puberty. Nakatulong po talaga yung vocal coaching sa akin. Nag-gain back po yung nawala kong tone and mas nagustuhan ko na yung boses ko ngayon kasi mas my body na siya and everything. And that's when I kind of gained my confidence back. Ako naman, I know who I am. And at the end of the day, what's important to me is what I think of myself and what my family also thinks. And for me, I guess the bashing was one of the things that inspired me more to do better as an artist, tsaka as a person as well. And I never really let it get to me and let it affect me emotionally and mentally. My advice to everyone who has doubts towards themselves is to just keep your faith parate. To everyone who gets criticism, use that criticism to fuel you, fuel your passion, and use it to motivate you to do better as well. If you're having days where you don't feel, you know, that good about yourself, talk to someone about it, or just even have time to yourself. Look at the positive side of things. Ano ba yung mga nangyari na sa buhay mo or na-receive mo na parang magagandang blessings or everything that you're thankful for? And after that, personally, after I think of all of those, I feel fulfilled and I feel like I've achieved so many things in it. And I feel better about myself. And that's my advice to everyone who doesn't always feel great or has doubts about themselves. I'm Darren Espanto, and just like you, I have those days where I feel bad about myself as well. But as long as you just keep your faith, and like Dory said in Finding Nemo, you just keep swimming, everything's going to be okay. And everything will be alright in the end.